Now we discuss the remaining points of unit number 6, that is nothing but configuration and comparability testing. The goal of configuration and comparability testing is to detect faults in the application while it is tested on a varied platforms and environments. The performance and system requirement specification formed during the start of the project provides a baseline for creating configuration and comparability test cases. So configuration testing determines the behavior of the software with respect to various configurations, whereas the comparability testing determines whether the web application behaves as expected with respect to various supported configurations. The configuration and comparability testing concerns checking web applications with differences such as browsers, Internet Explorer, users' interface components such as Java applets, operating systems such as Windows, Macintosh, Linux, internet connection types such as broadband, dial-up, leaseline, hardware devices such as CPU, RAM, CD-ROM, input devices, output devices, network cards, monitor, graphic display card, etc. Online services, multimedia services such as text, audio, video, database such as MS Access, SQL Server, Oracle, Sybase, and mobile devices such as Nokia, Motorola, Samsung, etc. The next part is security testing. Security is the procedure used to protect information from various threats. It is very important to protect sensitive and critical information and data while communicating over the network. The user wants implementing of a safeguard to protect personal, sensitive, and financial information. We want data to be accurate, reliable, and protected against unauthorized access. Security involves various threats such as unauthorized users, malicious users, messages sent to an unintended users, etc. Some of the security threats. So these are some security threats. The primary requirements of security include authentication. Is the information sent from an authenticated user? Access control. Is data protected from unauthorized users? Integrity. Does the user receive exactly what is sent? Delivery. Is the information delivered to the intended users? Reliability. What is the frequency of a failure? How much time does the network take a recover from failure? What are the measures to take the counter? The failure and non-repudiation, is the receiver able to prove that the data received came from specific sender. So web application must fulfill the above mentioned primary security requirement. Testing the threats and vulnerabilities in a web application is an important activity. The tester must check the web applications against all known internet threats. So virus threats are nothing but more sophisticated types of threats to web applications that may enter from the network. A virus is nothing but a program that modifies other programs by attaching itself to the program, which may infect the other programs also when host program executes. The virus may perform many functions such as deleting files and programs. The goal of testing the web application against the virus threats is to verify the methods of various preventions, detections, and removal. So, virus testing ensures that the antivirus software prevents the virus from entering into the system. The antivirus software efficiently detects an infection, removes all traces of that infection from the program, and restores the program to the original state. Periodical updates and scans are conducted to keep the system updated and prevent new viruses from penetrating into the system. So the security testing requires an experienced tester having true knowledge of internet-related security issues. The security expert needs to check the security issues, including the authentication, unauthorized access, confidentiality, virus, firewall, recovery from the failures. The next point is performance testing to ensure that the web applications can bear the load during the peak hours along with surviving the users in timely and reliable manner. Performance tests including load and trust tests need to be conducted. So one of the key advantages of web application is that numerous users can have access to the application simultaneously. Hence the performance of the applications during the peak periods must be tested and monitored carefully. Several factors that may influence performance, including the response time, memory available, network bandwidth, number of users, user type, time to download, varied the client machine configuration. The goal of performance testing is to evaluate the application's performance with respect to real world scenarios. So some following issues are addressed during the performance testing. It performance of the system during peak hours, points at which the system performance degrades or system fails, impact of degraded performance on the customer loyalty, sales and profits. So performance testing, the above issues requires metrics to apply to the system under test in order to measure with respect to various performance parameters. In that, most parameters we include is a load testing. Load testing involves testing the web applications under real world scenarios by simulating numerous users accessing the web applications simultaneously. It tests the web application by providing it maximum load. The development of plans for load testing should be as early as possible during the SDFC life cycle. Early testing will help in detection of problems prior to deployment of the web application, because load testing may follow the steps in order to ensure reasonable performance during, means it will be checked the peak hours based on defining the environment of load test, defining the testing strategy and determine the number of users. It is identify the potential metrics, choosing the right tool and executing the load test and interpreting the results. So performance testing, the load of testing team members must be determined to solve the specific problems related to following areas. Like team leader will take the charge to check the load test activity database. It is identify and remove the database problems, administrators database activities, networks. It set up the lab and identifies and removes the network bottlenecks. Business experts, it define the quality levels of the application. Performance analysis analyze the available measures, and quality management is ensures the quality testing. So next point is related to testing is the web application is nothing but stress testing. Stress testing involves execution of web applications with more, maximum and varying loads for long periods. Unlike performance load testing, stress testing evaluates the response of the system. As load testing is basically check how much the environment of computer system can capable to take the load, and stress testing, it will be released. The system is given a load beyond its specific limits. It is also used to monitor and check the reliability of web application when available resources are beyond the maximum uses. The behavior of the system is monitored to determine when the system under stress test fails and how this is recovered from the failure. So it will be may test the following things under the stress testing: is CPU and memory uses, response time, backend database, different types of users and concurrent users. The system performance is expected to degrade when a large number of users hit the website simultaneously. After the completion of stress test, the testing team must analyze the nodes, noted system performance, degradation points, and compare them with the acceptable performance of the system. So next testing point is a database testing. In web applications, many applications are database driven. For example, e-commerce related websites or business-to-business application, it is important for these applications to work properly and provide security to users. Sensitive data such as personal details and credit card information. So, testing data-centric on web application is important to ensure their error-free operations and increase the customer satisfaction. So, consider the example like for purchasing items from an online store, if the user performs a search based on some keywords and price preferences, database queries to create the database server. Suppose due to some programming fault in the query does not consider the price preferences given by the customer. This will produce the innumerable results. These kinds of faults must be tested and removed during the database testing. So which issues are important related to database testing are nothing but data validation, data consistency, data integrity, concurrency control and recovery, data manipulation operations such as addition, deletion, updation and retrieval of data, database security. Database must be tested for administrative level operations such as adding, deleting and updating an item in the database, and user operations such as searching an item from the database or providing personal details. In the example of online shopping website, the most common administrative operations are nothing but the administrative operations and user operations. The administrative operation based on inserting a new item into database, deleting an existing item from the database, updating an existing item from the database, and viewing the existing item from the database. And user operations are nothing but searching items from the database, registering into the website involves storing the user's personal details, placing an order involving storing user preferences and purchase details into the database, providing feedbacks involving storing information in the database, and tracking the status of the order placed. In database testing, the following aspects of correctness must be ensured. Are the database operations performed correctly? Is concurrent users' access to database handled correctly? Is the database fault tolerant? Are the performance requirements such as throughput and response time met? Are backup and recovery procedures designed and ensure interpreted services to the user? Does the database store to consistent state after crash recovery? Does the database have enough space and memory to store records and handle multiple administrative and user operations? The next point is post-deployment testing. This testing is conducted after delivering the software product to customers. So post-deployment testing may reveal those problems which went undetected before deployment of the web application. If detected, all the planning and testing carried out before deployment, obtaining user opinion is important for improvement of website, and it ensures that the website adapts to the needs of the user. User feedback may come in various forms, ranging from the reporting of faults to suggestions for improvements of the websites. The effective way to obtain a user's opinion is to get a questionnaire or survey filled by the user. The questionnaire survey can be used to detect trends and may provide valuable information for improvement of the websites. Once the user opinion is obtained, it is important to identify useful fault reporting suggestions and recommendations. The following criteria can be used to decide suggestions needs to attention. So frequency of suggestions, how many users have given the same suggestions or recommendation. If a small number of users are making same requests, then we must think twice before implementing the suggestion. Source of feedback. It is vital to make sure that suggestions come from regular users and not accidental users. Cost of implementing the suggestions, the correctness of the proposed change and its impact on the cost and schedule must be analyzed carefully. The benefits of implementing suggested idea to the business must be determined, and the impact of implementing the suggestions will change be compatible with the other functionalities of the website. It is important to obtain the answer to these questions as the results of implementing a change are sometimes unpredictable. So, figure shows the typical post-deployment testing procedure of application. Obtaining users' feedback, questionnaire or survey. It reviews those feedbacks, then estimate the cost of implementing the suggestions. Analyze the impact of implementing the suggestions. Then implemented and test suggested functionality and deploy the functionality. And then last point is web matrices. It can be effectively used in measuring the various attributes of web page. The following table provides the comprehensive web page measures. There are total 41 web page matrices which influence usability. These attributes matrices can be divided into two parts, page composition matrices and page formatting matrices, and overall page quality or assessment matrices. So most of the page composition and page formatting matrices can be easily calculated, but attributes that fall in the category 3, that is overall page quality or assessment matrices, requires design and or user evaluation. So web matrices are nothing but page composition. The matrices are, and the description are, number of words, means how many total number of words on page, body text, words that are body versus display text, line text, words, total words in links, number of links on a page, length of link text, words in the text for link, redundant links, repeated links on a page, embedded links, then backward links, within page links to other areas of the same page, readability, reading level of text on a page, number of explanation marks, content percentage, navigation percentage, portion of the page devoted to navigation page, title length, words in the page title, number of graphics, total images on the page, image size, number of pixels in an image. So font size, font page formatting is depend on the font, text, then number of lists, number of rows, colors, length, and overall page quality is based on the concept of information quality, image quality, link quality, load quality, and download speed. Layout quality and download speed. So web application differ from each other in various dimensions such as page content, page size, quality, reliability, screen coverage. These matrices mentioned in a table demonstrate quantitative web usability matrices that can provide useful insights into distinguished features of web pages. These matrices given us some ideas about thoroughness and effectiveness of web testing. Thank you.